Nos mandaron internacional para limitar la, la libertad de hablar sobre la religión. Si ustedes hacen un mandato así, ¿cómo van a asegurar que la gente de del país sigue las reglas?
The question is for all the countries, and basically the problem is, how would you assess that each country follows a mandate that will enforce regulation of freedom of speech?
Countries who are for the mandate. Now we recognize the delegate from Syria.
بكل بساطة من خلق الرقابة.
Quite simply through censorship.
My question is, how do you make sure that people follow the rules?
إذا حدا شك على حدا إنه عم بيخالف هالقانون ف بيصير في دعوة and it goes to court.
If it's not enforced, then the party that success can complain and it will be taken to court.
Thank you. Now we recognize the delegate of Korea.
Syria. 그 대표께서 말하셨듯이 이것은 법적인 문제이기 때문에 만약에 법을 만든다면 그럼 그것은 그 법정에서 해결할 수 있는 아주 간단한 문제라고 생각합니다.
Because through a mandate it will become a legal issue, it will be settled into court as the Syria said.
Just to add on to that, it would be a relatively, from a legal point of view, it's not going to be too problematic to enforce that.
Thank you. Now we recognize the delegate of the United States of America.
The United States of America would like to ask the assembled delegates as to whether they are of the opinion that if this mandate was to be voted for and put into law, that would the enforcement be on a national or international level?
Thank you. We now recognize the delegates of Germany.
Es sollte nur in den Ländern.
We believe that those delegations who sign this mandate will only abide by it within their regions, within their sovereignty.
Thank you. Now we recognize Andre as professor.
Thank you. In België is the situation relatively simple.
I speak French.
Nobody speaks French. De situatie is relatief eenvoudig. De vrije meningsuiting is uiteraard wettelijk geregeld. Nochtans worden over te erge uitspraken bestraft door de wet en worden verboden. Bijvoorbeeld het schenden van graven is verboden. Bijvoorbeeld het beledigen van mensen en het bekladden van gebouwen is verboden. Dus in België is de situatie relatief simpel. Free speech, of course, is ruled by law. However, people who go too far in the free speech are punished by law. For example, if you destroy if you destroy cemeteries, you destroy graves because you hate the symbols which are on the grave. That's forbidden by law. You can punish them, put in jail. If you, paint things, slogans on people's houses, that would be possible. So on the one hand, free speech exists. On the other hand, it is possible to limit excesses by punishing specific cases.